Once upon a time, there was a faraway world. It was ruled by the order of the sun and the power of light. Within this world, there was a land called Peopleville. And in forested area within it, there was a little town called Peopletown with many different inhabitants. One of them was Nightboy, who was a little boy who loved everyone and everyone loved him. One day, Nightboy decided to run away from home and help everyone that needed his help. While Nightboy was traveling around the village, he bumped into Lonzo, a funny-looking little creature who had no home and lived on the streets. However, Nightboy and Lonzo became best of friends, and Lonzo would follow Nightboy wherever he could. After a long while of helping people in the village, Nightboy solved everyone's problem, and there was no one else left to help. He knew he should have felt happy, but he didn't. There was still emptiness inside him. Feeling so low, he put his face in his hands and started crying. Feeling sad himself, Lonzo started crying as well. The sun cleared the sky and shined a ray of light on Nightboy and Lonzo. As they looked up, the sun spoke. "He who has sadness and darkness in his heart, follow me, and I will let light shine out of darkness. How can you take sadness from our little hearts? Our days on earth are like shadows without hope." To which Sun replied, "Believe in me, I will lead you to salvation." And so the sun sent Nightboy and Lonzo on a quest, where they will find what they seek. The sun promised, as long as they are on their journey, it won't go down. It will shine the entire way. Both Nightboy and Lonzo agreed to fulfill the quest, and with that, they went on their way. In one of the dark, deep, and cold caves lived an evil witch. Her only purpose was to bring darkness onto the hearts of everyone. The witch had many dark souls under her command. Hearing of the children, the witch became outraged. She knew that if the children finished their journey, their story would give hope to others. By her side, the witch had a little pet fox, and the witch would use him for her evil deeds. One day, the witch came to the fox and promised it the freshest and most delicious berries it would ever taste. Although the berries were old and rotten, the fox still ate them. The witch said to the fox, "My little fox, go where the children of the sun go, follow them, become their friends, and report back to me." So, the fox left in search of the children. After traveling for a long time, the fox came to a forest where the children were resting from their journey. He said to them, "You children, where are you going?" To which the children replied, "We are going to a faraway land where our hearts will find light." "May I join you on this journey?" "Of course, anyone can," said the children wholeheartedly. So the children went on with their journey, going through many different lands and forests, with the evil witch spying on them through the fox's eyes. One day, after the children were traveling for a long, long time, they reached a land with a very high trees, as high as the sky. Upon seeing the high trees, the witch knew this was her perfect time to conclude the journey, and she decided to cast a spell on the children. In an instant, all around the children, black spiders appeared, crawling toward them slowly. They huddled in fear, but Lonzo was not scared, so he grabbed two sticks and rubbed them together. Fire sparked from the sticks in Lonzo's hands. He quickly threw them in some hay, and the fire spread instantly. The spiders ran in all directions away from the fire. The witch was mad, but understood that together the children were too strong, and that the only way to defeat them was to spoil them individually. So, the witch set on her way to reach the children of the sun. After much time, the children reached a beautiful mountain valley where they decided to rest, unaware that the witch was descending on the valley. As Lonzo was looking for firewood, the witch came to him and said, "Lonzo, I have come here to help you. I can see into your heart and I see night burning it. Would you not want to be a normal little boy?" It's true, he was in love with Nedby, but never thought Nedby would even look at him the way Lonzo wished. Ruled by his emotions, Lonzo agreed. But as payment, the witch said that he must give her some of his essence, and he did. Meanwhile, the little fox was searching for food in the forest. Looking for some time, he found a branch full of berries, so he ate some. For the first time, the fox's heart felt warm and at home. And then the fox heard the sun speak. "My child, you have led a dark life, but you have good inside you. I will show you another way. But to reach the light, you will have to sacrifice your past." Without saying another word, the fox jumped and ran to find the children. He knew what the sun has asked of him. The evil witch didn't waste any time and found Nedby. But before letting him see her, she took out Lonzo's essence and used it with her magic to turn into Lonzo. She came to Nedby and said, "I found this delicious apple. I want you to have it." Nedby, unsuspicious, took it and then took a big bite out of it. Nedby suddenly fell to his knees in pain. His heart was being consumed with darkness. The witch turned back into her normal form and laughed. "You fool! How could you think you were a match to my power? You won't escape the shadows now." At that very moment, the little fox came out of the forest, seeing what has happened. The fox, knowing the witch's evil tricks, jumped towards Nedby and started to lick his chest. But as the evil was pouring into the fox's little heart, it filled it almost entirely. And with that, the little fox took its last breath and died. Coming around from his death, Nedby stood up and said, "You are an evil and dark being. You have fulfilled your wand. Now be gone from the sun's glare." The witch laughed and said, "It is I who will be casting you out. My powers will crush you and anyone who stands against me." Nedby calmly said, "Your powers are mighty, but darkness will always exile in the face of light." He raised his arms and said, "By the power of the sun and the glory of light, I am commanding the enlightenment of your soul." Suddenly, the sun started to get brighter and brighter. and then a ray of light beamed from the sand onto the witch. And as she screamed, in a puff of smoke, she disappeared. Just the neighbor saw Lonza standing out of sight. He recognized him straight away and said, "What has happened to you?" To which Lonza replied, "I fell for the witch's trick and betrayed you for the sake of my vanity." Nedby took Lonza's hand and said, "You didn't need to change the way you look, Lonza, because I love you the way you are." Then the clouds parted and once more the sun spoke. "Behold, my children, your journey is at an end. You faced evils and made your choices, and by them you will have to stand. Remember, your past does not determine your future, so don't let what you can't do prevent you from doing what you can, for the world is at your feet. Be wise and brave, and always seek light." And the sun started to set for the first time in a very long time. And even though it was going to be dark, the children were not scared. They knew, even if it's dark outside, there will always be light in their hearts. Lock your parents out, cut a rug, twist and shout, wait.